Hey everyone, Nick here, and I wanted to jump on to give you a really quick design tip that will elevate your slides, and it will also add a layer of accessibility to your presentation. And by that, I mean allow your audience to read the text on a slide. Sometimes you have a slide like this. This is a tweet that was posted by the American Alliance of Museums during their recent conference last week in Denver. And it's a presentation from Eastern State Penitentiary. It's a historic prison museum. They do amazing work there, and I want their presentations to really shine. And this is a picture, and you know, maybe the picture of the tweet doesn't really do it justice. Maybe if I was actually in the room, it would look a little bit different. But you can see here, we have a really powerful set of quotes from participants in a program that they were putting on, and a beautiful photo that is a full slide photo behind. But if I was in the audience, I'm not sure I'd be able to read this text. It's white text on top of the photo, and there's a lot of different places in that photo that the text kind of becomes a little bit washed out. You can't really read that quote. So I wanted to go on and share a really quick design tip that you can use when you have text or a quote on top of a photo to make that photo or to make that text really stand out from the photo, but the photo will still be there, so you can still get the really nice look and feel, really elevated look and feel with that photo behind the text. So I'm gonna go over here to my PowerPoint slide and just show you this. So here's an example, just a stock photo that I put up on a slide, and I have this block of text here that you probably really can't read when it's up there presented on the slideshow. So let's go down here, and I want to show you two ways that I can think of to make this text really stand out from the photo. The first way is to fill the background of your slide with a really rich and deep color. So if I click out here, you can actually see the photo right here. I'm going to go ahead and just click on the background of the slide, go over to the format background menu over here, and right here it's set to solid fill, it's set to white, but let's go ahead and make it a very deep blue color. All right, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put the photo back so that the photo still fills the slide, and with the photo selected, we're going to adjust the transparency of the photo, and that's going to make the photo basically see-through to a degree that we set. So go ahead up here to the picture format menu. And then actually, we don't need the picture format menu in this case because the format menu is up here on the right side. But I'm going to click on the photo icon over here, and right under photo transparency, you can see that you can set the transparency details here. It's set to 0%, but let's take the slider bar and just start sliding it across. And you can see now it's starting to make the background of the slide pretty dark, and you can start seeing the text. Let's go all the way up to 70% there. You can also just set it by typing in the number, the percentage of transparency. Now let's look at this in slideshow mode, and you can really see that now the text, the white text, really stands out or pops on that slide. Now another way that you can accomplish the exact same thing is just by adding a graphic, basically just a rectangle or a shape on top of that photo, and that won't decrease the value of the photo. It won't make the photo transparent, but it will also give you the same effect of having that text really pop and stand out on that photo. So let's go ahead into the insert menu and insert a rectangle here. I'm just gonna go and set this rectangle all the way to the dimensions of my slide. We're gonna drag it over and all the way down. And now what we want to do is we want to send this photo backwards. So I want to go right click and then not send to back completely, but I'm going to click on this and it's going to send one layer back. So if I say send backward, it'll go behind the first thing that pops up here, which is the text. So if I do that, now the text is in front of that shape. I'm going to go ahead now and format the shape with the transparency. So the transparency, I can do the same thing and slide this over, and now the photo, you can still see it's showing through that shape, and it looks really, really nice. Now I'll probably go ahead and get rid of the outline of that shape, we don't really need it. And then maybe let's set it to even greater, let's see, maybe actually less there on the photo, so 20% there. You can play with the color of the photo, you can make it darker, you can play with any of the colors there, orange, red, all of these things. This is a really great trick that you can use in your slides and your reports to make text stand out on top of your photo and add that extra layer of accessibility. So even somebody way in the back of the room when you're presenting this in a slideshow will see that text. So I hope that you'll be able to use this trick in your next PowerPoint slide presentation or your report. If you like this video, I hope you'll give it a thumbs up and make sure to click the bell next to it. Subscribe and make sure to click the bell next to it. You will get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this for you, and I hope to see you all next time.